It's a beautiful day here at the South Pole. And I want to take you inside and introduce you to our machinist. Alright, I am here in MAPO with our machinist, Dave Pernic. Dave, why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do here?
My title is the science machinist. I work for the University of Chicago, and they staff this shop as a courtesy to all of the science that happens on this station.
And you do more than just the science, right? You also make parts for other parts of the station as well as needed sometimes?
Yeah, I'm really the only machinist,
right?
So you could say, but I am staffed by science.
Right.
And originally the shop was built when the dark sector was a science center. They built one facility. They were bringing in all kinds of new projects, and they thought, well, so everybody doesn't have to bring all their own tools,
right,
and all their own material and everything else. We have some facility in order to manufacture some part in case we need them, because
right,
you can't just order the stuff
right
and have it ship here the next day like we could at home.
Right, especially over the winter when we don't get any flights or cargo in. If a part breaks and a new one needs to be made, this is the guy you come talk to. So how many times have you been down here in total?
I've been coming down since 1992,
okay,
I think. Almost all the summer since 1992.
Wow, okay. And back then it was the dome, right? The dome station, not the elevated station that you've been seeing me show.
That's right. This is my third winter, but I've spent a lot of summers here, more than 20.
And what do you think comparing summer to winter, since you're probably, out of all the people on station, you have the best idea of comparing the two? What do you think?
Oh, wow. It's a pretty different animal. Summertime,
yeah,
is quite busy.
Yeah.
It's a little bit crowded.
Yeah.
Everybody comes down with their own agenda for the science people, right? So a science person might come down here and they might be here for 3 weeks and they're like, I got to get my stuff to work. The complicated stuff is already supposed to come down, but we also work as fabricators. We work with the engineers to design a lot of stuff. A lot of paper napkin engineering happens.
Right.
In the wintertime, if everything's running right,
right,
I don't have very much coming to me as emergency, we got to keep this going. It's like a mindset,
mm-hmm,
and how can I make myself the most useful for the long term?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm here in case something breaks down and they really need to get one of these expensive telescopes up and running.
Right.
That doesn't happen very often. We organize the shop. We
right
make new tooling and repair the walls in the building and
yeah,
whatever else we can do.
Whatever.
Come out here every day, you know, whether there's a list of things to be done or not.
Sure.
And
sure,
and have that routine keep going. So it's a totally different animal.
Right. Any other thoughts about working down here that you think is interesting?
Well, sure, it's interesting to come down here, otherwise I wouldn't keep doing it. I mean, it kind of fits my lifestyle. I've been going to Alaska in the summer seasons at home, and I come down here in the summer seasons here, and that's kind of a good fit. I've helped build this entire dark sector.
Mm-hmm.
So when I first came down here, there was nothing out here at all.
See.
So I've helped put a lot of these things together.
Wow.
I worked as an ice cube driller for
eight seasons. The hot water drill, right?
Right.
Oh, very cool. And you've also had a hand in making a few of the pole markers that we replace every year too, that's right?
Right. So actually before this shop even existed,
uh-huh,
I think I made my first pole marker in 96, and I used the lathe that was in the VMF at that time.
Okay, no kidding.
In the garage.
Very cool. If somebody wanted to get your job here whenever you decide to retire, what would they need to do? What kind of experience would they need?
You got to have some machining experience.
Uh-huh.
A lot of the new guys might have only worked on CNC machines, but they've had maybe some more manual capacity machines as secondary or finish work.
Uh-huh.
We don't have any CNC stuff here at all.
Okay.
Other than an engraver,
right,
that we used. We don't have any computer control. With this, we have all manual stuff. So anytime I got to cut a circle or something, I got to use a turntable.
Right.
The machining aspect is more old school.
And Dave also was the one that got us hooked on a new card game that, well, new to most of us here at the South Pole. You want to talk about that a little bit?
Cribbage is hardly a new card game.
It's pretty old, but it's new to all of us. Now we play two or three times a day at mealtime, so it's a lot of fun. Another thing I just remembered is you also play a few instruments. I'll hear a harmonica and I'm like, where's that coming from? And I look in the greenhouse and Dave is in there playing.
I have this giant list of things that I was going to do for self-improvement.
Yeah,
right?
Me too.
All kinds of study courses I was going to do. I was really going to finally learn how to play guitar. I was going to learn how to play ukulele. But the fact is, I really only know a couple of songs on each still. And my harmonica may have gotten a little bit better this year.
Yeah. All right. Well, Dave, thanks a lot. I appreciate you coming on here and giving an interview. And stay tuned for some more.